So in our earlier class, we learned about what is resistance. Now let us try to understand what is explained to us in activity 12.2. Now in this activity, we are given a circuit consisting of an ammeter, a 4-cell battery, a switch key, and we are given a gap called XY. Now this gap X and Y is common in all the circuits. This gap XY is present in all the circuits. And we are asked to take in the first circuit a nichrome wire of unknown resistance. And in the second circuit we have a 10-volt bulb. And in the third circuit we are asked to take a torch bulb. And then we are asked to find out the amount of current that flows through the ammeter in the case of nichrome wire, the current flowing through the ammeter in the second place when I attach the 12-volt bulb, 10-volt bulb, and the current flow in the third circuit when a torch bulb is used. Now, as we know that different components will consider different amounts of current, that means the amount of current in all these three ammeters will be definitely different. Now, in this activity, what we observe is that current is different for different components. That means the amount of current flowing through each and every circuit will be different. Now the obvious question is why it is different for each and every component. As we know that certain components offer easy path for the flow of current. Certain components offer easy path for the flow of current, while the others resist their flow of current. That means some components will always allow easily the current to flow through, whereas certain amount of components will resist the flow of current. And we also know that motion of electrons in a circuit will constitute electric current. That means when we say the current is flowing, there is motion of electrons in the circuit. But the electrons, however, cannot completely are free to move in a conductor. That means the electrons on their own cannot move completely and freely in a conductor. Motion of electrons is always retarded by the resistance of the conductor. That means the movement of electrons in a nichrome wire will be different, in a torch bulb will be different, and in a 10-watt bulb will be different. So the motion of electrons is always retarded by a resistance. So based on resistance, we can define four different types of substances. What are they? A good conductor, a resistor, a poor conductor, and an insulator. Now what is a good conductor? A component of given size that offers low resistance. A component of a given size that offers low resistance is a good conductor. That means generally metallic wires can be considered here. Now what is a resistor? A conductor having some appreciable resistance. Appreciable means a limited amount of resistance. So, if a conductor offers low resistance, then it is a good conductor. If a substance offers appreciable resistance, then we call it as a resistor. A component of identical size that offers a higher resistance. That means, if there is high resistance to the flow of current, we call such one as a poor conductor. Finally, an insulator is a component which offers maximum resistance to the flow of current. So anything that offers maximum resistance to the flow of current is called an insulator. So based on resistance, we have a good conductor, resistor, poor conductor, and insulator. Okay. Next, we will be learning about the factors on which resistance depends. So this is an example of the activity given in your textbook, activity 12.3, where we are asked to do a particular activity. So in activity 1, you are asked to take a nichrome wire of length 1 meter. Here we are taking a nichrome wire of length 1 meter, being connected to a battery, an ammeter, and a switch key. So here, the nichrome wire has a length of 1 meter, and it has certain area of cross section. Area of cross section is represented by this shade. So we have 1 meter nichrome wire attached to the circuit. So when I switch on the key, The ammeter will show at an amount of reading. So let the reading be 2 amperes. In the next activity, we are asked to make a similar nichrome wire. Now this is another nichrome wire, but this time the length has been increased to twice the earlier length. That means we increase the length of the wire. That means when the electrons flow from the negative end to the positive end, they have to travel more distance. That means the resistance offered to the flow of electrons will be more. That means if the resistance is more, the total amount of current in the circuit will become half the original resistance. That is equal to half of 2. Because earlier we have a resistance of current of 2 amperes. Now the amount of current will be equal to how much? 1 ampere. So one thing what we did is, when we took a wire of length 1 meter, more current was flowing. But when we increased the length by 2 times the original length, that means when I increased the length to 2 meters, the total amount of resistance will increase and the total current in the circuit is equal to 1 ampere. So what can we conclude from this? That resistance of a conductor depends on length. That means if L increases, resistance will increase. Now, in the case 3, again, we have the same nichrome wire that is of 1 meter length. But here if you observe carefully, the thickness of the wire is more. Here the thickness is more, here the thickness is less. That means, now we have taken a 1 meter nichrome wire, but with more area of cross-section. So here, more area will offer more space for the electrons to move. That means, the electrons can move freely and the amount of resistance is quite low. That means, thicker is the wire, easily they can pass through and the charges can move freely. So, there is more amount of current which can flow into the conductor. That means, when the nichrome wire is of 1 meter length, only 2 amperes of current. But if they increase the area of cross-section, definitely the amount of current in the circuit will increase. So, what can we learn from these two? That area of cross-section is inversely proportional to resistance. That means, a thick wire has more resistance than a thin wire. What does it mean? If you take a wire of much thickness, that means if the area of cross-section is more, the resistance will be less. If the area of cross-section is less, the resistance offered to the flow of current is more. That means R is inversely proportional to A. That means if A increases, R decreases. If A decreases, R will increase. Here area means one need to understand that it is the thickness of the material. So a thicker wire will offer less resistance to the flow of current, whereas a thin wire, if the area of cross section is less, the resistance offered will be more. So what is the second factor which we can learn? Resistance of a conductor depends on area of cross section. What does it mean? If the area of the wire is more, the thickness of the wire is more, the resistance offered is always less. That means more current can flow into the circuit. Next, in the case 4, instead of taking a nichrome wire, we are taking a copper wire. We know that copper is a good conductor. So a good conductor always offers less resistance to the flow of current. So here what happened is, we changed the material. So in case 1, we have a nichrome wire with 1 meter length. Here we have a copper wire of 1 meter length. The area of cross section of nichrome as well as the copper remains the same. But if you observe carefully, the amount of current in the copper wire will be more compared to nichrome. Why? Because nichrome is an alloy of nickel, chromium, manganese, and iron. And alloys offer greater resistance rather than a conductor. So copper wire being a conductor does not allow any resistance to the flow of current. So the amount of resistance will be less. So the current in the circuit will be more. Why? Because copper is a very good conductor of electricity. So in this case, we have the maximum current flowing into the circuit. So from this case, when we compare case 1, what we can learn is, resistance depends on the nature of material. If the material is made up of an alloy, the resistance offered will be more. If the nature of material is a conductor, then the resistance offered will be less. So overall, what did we learn? Resistance of a conductor depends on 3 factors. Number 1, length. number 2 area of cross section, number 3 nature of material. So resistance is directly proportional to length. That means if the length increases, resistance will increase. If the length decreases, resistance will decrease. So resistance is directly proportional to length. In the same way, resistance is inversely proportional to one way. That means resistance and area of cross section are inversely proportional to each other. In simple words, I can say, if the area of cross section is more, resistance offered will be less. If the area of cross section is less, resistance offered to the cross current will be more. So from this equation and this equation, we can conclude that R is proportional to L by A. Now if I remove this proportionality constant, I will get a formula to calculate resistance, that is R is equal to rho into L by A. This constant is called rho, which is called specific resistance or resistivity. So here rho is called specific resistance or resistivity. So in our next concept, I will explain what is meant by resistivity, its formula, the SI units, etc. So we have learned that resistance is directly proportional to length. That means if the length of the conductor is more, the resistance offered is more. If the length of the conductor is less, the resistance offered will be less. We learned this now in the earlier activity. And R is proportional to area of cross section, inversely proportional to the area of cross section. That means if area increases, resistance decreases, and if area of cross section is more, then the resistance will be less. That means if I take a thick wire, then the resistance offered will be less, and if I take a thin wire of less area, then the resistance offered will be more. So from 1 and 2, R is proportional to L by A, and resistance can be calculated by rho L by A. Here, what is rho? Rho is a constant called resistivity or specific resistance. So this proportionality constant is equated to a constant called rho. That is, the symbol is called the rho, but the value is called resistivity or specific resistance. Now, in this formula, if I substitute the length of the wire to be 1 meter and area of cross section to be 1 meter square, as given here, I will get R is equal to rho into L by A, which is equal to rho into length being 1 meter, area of cross section being 1 meter square. I get resistance is equal to resistivity. Now, when is resistance equal to resistivity? If I have a conductor of length 1 meter and area of cross section 1 meter square. Now it's our duty to learn what actually do we mean by resistivity or specific resistance. Now here let us consider a cube of material. If you see, the height of the cube is 1 meter, the breadth is 1 meter and the length is 1 meter. That means it is a unit cube. And I am trying to pass the current across perpendicularly through the cube. So now I can define resistivity as, resistivity of a material is defined as the resistance offered by the cube of a material of side 1 meter. That means, now if I try to pass the current through this cube of material, it will be offered with some amount of resistance by this material. So the resistance offered by this cube of material of length 1 meter, breadth 1 meter and height 1 meter will be called the resistivity. So here if we see the definition, resistivity of a material is defined as nothing but the resistance. Resistivity is nothing but resistance. But by whom? It is offered by a cube of material of side 1 meter when the current is flowing perpendicularly to the opposite face of the cube. That means resistivity is nothing but resistance offered to this current by this cube of material, which is having the dimensions as length 1 meter, breadth 1 meter and height. That means if I find out the resistance of this cube, which is offering resistance to the flow of current, I am calculating what? Resistivity. Otherwise, we can also define resistivity as, the resistivity of a material is defined as the resistance offered by a cylindrical conductor of cross-sectional area 1 meter square and length 1 meter when current flows perpendicularly to the opposite side of the cylinder. So I want to define resistivity one other way. What I can say is, I need to take a material of wire 1 meter in length and its area of cross section should be 1 meter square. That means I have a material of length 1 meter and area of cross section being 1 meter square, that means the thickness being 1 meter square, if I try to pass current perpendicularly through it, then the resistance offered to this flow of current is defined as resistivity. So in Malla you can say that resistivity is nothing but resistance, but the material is offering resistance because of its dimensions, then we call it as resistivity or specific resistance. So whatever the material will be, every material will offer resistance to the flow of current, and if that is calculated, we call it as a specific resistance. Now coming to the formula of specific resistance or resistivity, we know that R is equal to rho L by A, where rho is for resistivity. So if I want to calculate resistivity, then I will transfer this A to the other side and this length will go to the denominator. So rho is equal to R into L by A is the formula to calculate resistivity of the material. Now if I want to find out the SI unit of resistivity, the SI unit of resistivity is equal to unit of resistance into unit of area by unit of length. So we know SI unit of resistivity is ohm, unit of area is meter into meter, unit of length is meter. So cancelling out meter and meter, I get the SI unit of resistivity to be ohm meter. So what can I do? I can write ohm meter as the SI unit of resistivity. Now coming to the factors on which resistivity depends. The only factor on which resistivity depends is temperature. That means resistance is affected only by temperature, but not any other factor of length or area of cross section. Now coming to the common factor. The common factor on which both resistance and resistivity depend is temperature. That means resistance changes with temperature. If the temperature is increased, the resistance of the wire will increase. And resistance also changes only if there is increase in temperature. So the only common factor on which both resistance and resistivity depend is temperature. The only factor on which resistivity depends is temperature, and resistivity does not change with length or area of cross section.